Now, folks, Luca, Asia per Trades Market dropped down a little bit, went down to 448. Support was 446, down at this low. Kind of got held and then got a bounce. Still below the ATMA, so I need to see a back above the ATMA and eventually break out above 454 with target 460 and 466. Support 446. And then further down the 50 SMA. Into the individual stocks, decent day today. Day trades quite active and swings so-so. Okay, so we got the ANI. ANI, day trade, act well for the first part of the trading session, rally through here, 27, pullback retest, extended 722, pullback retest. This point was, for me, was done when it broke the BWP, and then tried again. Give a second push, made a double top here at 740, then going further and pull back. On the daily chart, I do like the reversal with volume. So keep an eye on it. This was a recent swing idea, I believe. Right there. Yeah, swing idea. And reached the target near 11. And this looks like a reversal. I want to see a back above this eye. That would be 768. And then 764, yeah, 768. We target 9, 11, 13, and 15. Support is today low and yesterday low. ARQQ, a day trade that was challenging, but nevertheless performed well. Here, as soon as you open, let's get to the moment right here, popped, rallied to the two targets, 1577 and 1868. Pullback retest, this was steep, for me was done when you did that. Consolidated, tried again, and then failed to extend. Here, made a pop, if you put a trend line right there, which is how we had it. Popped, head fake, and then it went down very hard. On the daily chart, it looks good, as this is a new company. I think it's been a split of a different company or merger. I can't remember exactly. But anyway, the volume is good. So this shows excitement. Yesterday was big. Today is huge. Presence of upper shadows and it's very volatile. Nevertheless, it shows bullish sentiment. The support is 14 today, low precisely. 13. 13 is the support. And then 11, 20. Any pullback, it could fill this gap. I'm looking for a break above to the high, 19, with targets at 22, 26, 31. Ather, a very good day trader, took part with this one, worked very well. And I looked here, and then I pulled back, consolidated, found this pennant, and then eventually was able to break out and reach the target 9 and 10.48, pullback retest. It weakened into the close, normal. A feather, it's down in the after hour market. I added to the swing idea because of the volume that was coming in and the break above the 50 SMA. Currently, it's holding, so that's the area that needs to confirm and hold. It's also channel top, so we'll see if this is a resistance and we'll pull back. So far, it is so. Or if it's able to break and hold, in which case we have a falling channel breakout and could lead much higher. 12, 15, 17, and 20. Support, it's near the 8, let's see, those lows. 8, 18, 8, 20, somewhere around there. And then today low. BBIG made a pop, came high to 1248, 1249, was a day trade also. From the base, nice double bottom, pop the VWP. Rally to 1160 and 1240 also took part of this trade and then broke. This was the decisive move when it came down on heavy volume, done. A little bit of a bounce, rolled over, a little bit of a bounce, rolled over. So it's making lower highs and lower lows and wants to go lower, looks like it, at least. Volume is great, but the presence of a dark pool activity around 1112 is keeping the price lower, which is a possibility for going further down. Now, this one is breaking above this high. There was the all-time high prior to today, 1163. So we're still below it. needs to break an old above it before it can go any higher. And again, today high, that's a big resistance, 1249. Swing idea, still bullish with the technicals, but it could pull back further with the support at the 3MA and then the 8MA. Lower nothing. Cotti, ugly. Cotti broke out here with the volume. And so when I usually see these price tells us the ones to go higher, it did a few days extension. And I added to the swing idea, if you broke and hold this high, the breakout high, 995, then it didn't. Popped the head above it and then pulled back. Showed weakness for 4 days. And today imploded, went all the way down to 8. There was a dark pool activity at 840, currently above it, which means bearish for now. Number volume increase. In my opinion, this wants to go lower. It could get a bounce to fill this gap up to 920, especially if it's able to break above 840 and the moving averages. But if it takes out today low and then breaks below the 200 simple the moving average, this is a short, 740 and 630. I don't like it. Dash, a pop of this ascending triangle, the multi-week consolidation, popped, decent volume, is more to confirm the breakout, 213, 233, and 225 are the targets. Support, tight, yesterday low, 190, 192, and then the 50 SMA. DDOG, good consolidation for several weeks. It's testing all-time high and the target, 140, 45. Volume is good, looks ready to make a move. Next target, okay, so the high is 141.14. Next target is 150, 160, 172. Support today low and this candle low at 127, 126, 127. DD, as the Chinese stocks are showing some challenges, they're back into troubles with the government, a little bit of regulations still pressing, causing tension in the Chinese stock market and stocks. DDI, yesterday reached the target, today did a reversal, 180 degree. It's not a bearish kicker, but it's a negative move. Number volume increasing, smaller than the past 2 days, but still, if number volume continues to increase and price breaks today low, it will pull back further. So look for a consolidation, it's okay. It needs to come back above yesterday closing price at 918, and then it needs to take out 1020. It targets 1150, 1270, and 1440 if it does make the reversal. The support is this candle low, 870, and then 870 and 8, period. GSAT, very good day trade. Also took part of this one. Popped, pullback, consolidated, and then broke out with the good volume. Did a little bit of a pullback, didn't get the follow through right there. So this was kind of a head fake. Came down, tested the VWP, hold it, brief fell below it, but it's holding the support. And then eventually broke out into an hour into the close, extending as high as 274. On the daily chart is bullish, fully breakout. It's took out this breakout high, it's 242. And the next resistance will be this high, 298.3. Take the whole structure, this thing was up at 1768 in 2006, so a while ago, which means there is room for expansion. Right now it's only $2.60. So I would expect an extension, especially with this kind of volume, 3, 350, 420, 5, and 6. Those are my next targets. Support after the candle, that's 230, and today low at 210. GSKY. GSKY, I spotted earlier, the volume caught my attention, and this formation is a rectangular formation. Attempted to break out this recent high, 833. It's testing the resistance I'm watching, 848. Keep an eye on that one, because there is a low. Let's see if I can find that. Is it this one? No. Chart.
Let's see if we can. Okay, take a closer look. This thing has been highly discounted. So hello. Okay, oh, hello right there. Okay, so there it is, 848. Somewhere around this level, there, and then somewhere around this level, and then this high. Okay, 848, yes, found it right there. Okay, so it needs to pop and hold above the high, and then there's quite a bit of resistance ahead, but these technicals show bullish pattern. So look, needs to break and hold the 848, volume intraday, and if it does, and this volume continues to grow, looking for 950, 1050, 1170, and 13. Support 790, and this red candle low is 740. KWEB, swing idea. These Chinese ETF, again, experiencing some tension in the Chinese market. This is right below the 50 SMA. It needs to break and hold above the level to go higher, 57, 64, and 71 are the targets moving forward. Already reached one. Support is 52, 52, 51, and then 47. Path. This one is ugly. Every time seems like it's making a bottom, a base, a breaks. It's a base, a breaks. This looks like, unless this is a island reversal, which means price drops down significantly, makes a doji, and then the following day gaps higher, holds the support, and then moves up. So that's the island doji, bullish. But right now, because of the volume, because of the break below this low, has some bearish presence, sellers, the presence of sellers. So if this one breaks below today low, 55.28, it's gonna go lower. Looking for, and it could be a short, I had a short idea if it does that. 53, 50, and 47, the support areas and targets if it breaks. And the resistance will be today high, 58.4. Palantir is taking a break. Yesterday, as I mentioned, if you recall, spotted a dark pool activity, quite large one at 27, 26, 80, and did a pullback on volume increase. So this is a hurdle right now. So the support is 25, currently holding primary support. The break below that will come and retest the 50 SMA. That's 25, 23.50. So it needs to stabilize above 25, break it back above 26.80, and then my target are 28, 31, and 34. RBLK, that's going up again, probably. So this one is a company that is rather unique. Rocket Lab, it's a competitor, second largest company with providing rides to the space for astronauts, not idiots, sorry, not regular people. And good volume came in a few days ago. Susan are the swing idea, fully support the choice, big move, reached the target 14.37 and today, yesterday, at 16.46. Maintains a bullish look. I enter a position today. Let's see if it does make the extension. 18, 21, and 23 are my targets. Support is 14. For me, that's the area that needs to hold. And then below that will be the 18. Root was a brief day trade, just spotted, didn't do much. In fact, we made a consolidation, popped to 660, 670, and then pulled back and broke the support back below the DWP. However, because of this bottom and the volume that came in today, might have more to say. Keep an eye on it, especially if some of those ready groups pick it up. The resistance here, 7 and the 50 SMA, break above the 50 SMA could extend to 8, 9, 20, 10, 15, 12, those are my targets. Support will be today low. Swing it. Sava Short continues the ugly momentum of this company. Today broke below the 200 simple moving average, came to the target 44.59 to the penny, two penny lower than that, so reach the target. And I don't like the look of it. I think because the channel bottom might get a bounce, but it looks very weak, very vulnerable. If he breaks the 200 and fell, currently is holding, but if he breaks and fell, the next support is 40, 36, and then 31. Resistance, 50 and 55. Snow, down. Okay, so Snow popped, made a good move today, came as high as 320, down in the after hour market for some reason, maybe a secondary offering or something disappointing. I can't find it right now as I take a brief look to the news, nothing that I can see. No, I'll post it if I see something. Anyway, Snow is a swing idea and most importantly, an investment idea, long-term position, good action for the past few days. And the first target, if you swing it, is 326 and then 374. Support as a swing will be this red candle low, 298, and then down at the 50 SMA. Currently, 273. UPST keeps on giving. They came as high as 277 almost. Channel top, volume is good. The pullback got the bounce and closed well. This could be a hanging man if he opens lower and comes down. But if he moves sideways and forms another base and then takes out the 280 basically, then he will try to go higher, 320 and 379. Targets. Support 80 May and then those lows near to 10 to 15. And finally, ZI. ZI is frustrating. It's been trading nicely. And then yesterday we initiated the swing and this thing went down. There was a dead pull activity around 65 and it's below it. So that's a little bit worrisome. Primary support 63. Secondary support 59. I'd say cautious with this one because of the pattern. This is a bearish kicker on some volume. I don't like what I see right now. Now market also came down, but market also recovered. This one did not. So be careful. If he opens lower, it will pull back further to retest the 50. The pattern is bullish overall, but the entry right now might not. So be careful if it opens lower and goes down. To start working is to break an old 67, 63 all-time high, and my target is 72, 79, 86, and eventually 95. All right, folks, thanks for watching. Good trading. See you tomorrow.